These scribblings were undoubtedly the mark of a tormented mind. Something wasn't right in the poor mechanic's head. Was a motorless car. The mechanic sure had an odd way to go about repairing things. Carl hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the wealth contained in Lamotte's lands. bit of gas, a new spark plug, and the key, and this thing would run perfectly. All he needed to do now was to find all that. Wanted to know more about this oddball mechanic. Surely he would find something somewhere on this land. Carl wanted to know more about this oddball mechanic. Surely he would find something somewhere on this land. It was a typical shack, just like the ones you hear about in Quebecois legends. Local lumberjacks used it to rest and twice a day heat up their pea soup. Who quits a game one step away from victory? Leftover food, the clothes, the general warmth of the place, no evidence of escape. Carl was sure of it. People were here not long ago, and they expected to come back. Crossbow bolts had the same origin. Carl was sure of it. Who was it? And more importantly, what was being hunted like this? Without a single window to brighten things up, the inside of the cabin was almost pitch black. Beware of close encounters of knee and furniture. Solitaire, a card game only hermits can truly enjoy. Carl felt depressed at the thought of playing this. Everything was set up for a well-deserved snack. It seemed like the place hadn't been empty for long, but without knowing exactly why, Carl had the feeling no one was coming back anytime soon. This cabin doesn't look like a bunkhouse, especially with the missing stove and chimney. Carl was intrigued at the secrets possibly hidden here.
Thank you.
wintry atmosphere surrounded the house. The soundlessness of the area suggested it was empty. When finding a boot, one wonders what became of the foot. The key, which seemed to be meant for a padlock, bore an inscription reading Clutze et Fils. A company name. Better keep an eye open. Businesses weren't exactly numerous around these parts. Money in a jar. What a shame. Carl would have loved cookies. Pay stub for some undoubtedly harsh lumberjack work. Alexandre Blais felled trees and chopped woods for Clutze et Fils. The spirograph amused Carl. It was a nice modern toy. Aside from being repetitive by nature and completely useless, still, it found its way into many Quebecois homes. A window left open in that weather? Perhaps something had to be watched. The sheets were in such a way that indicated a rude awakening, followed by a hurried escape. What had happened here? Welcome to Alibaba's Cave, Lumberjack Edition. Surely Carl would find something worth his time in here. Thank you.